Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture of Engineering Hydrology. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about how can we measure the precipitation. The precipitation is collected and measured in a rain gauge. The rain gauge may also called as pulvometer, ombometer, hydrometer or udometer. So a rain gauge may have several names, but the main function of a rain gauge is to collect and measure the rain or precipitation. There are basically two types of rain gauges. The first one is non-recording type rain gauge and the second one is recording type rain gauges. In India, most extensively used non-recording type rain gauge is Simon's rain gauge. And some commonly used recording type rain gauges are tipping bucket type rain gauge, weighing bucket type rain gauge and float type rain gauge. The float type recording rain gauge may also called as natural siphon type recording gauge. Okay. Natural siphon type. Now, before going into the detailed discussion about this rain gauges, we should know an important information that the rain or precipitation is measured in terms of depth. Okay, so let me write it here. Precipitation is measured in terms of depth. Okay, so this is an important information. Now we are going to discuss about non-recording gauges. The non-recording gauges are those gauges which do not produce a continuous rainfall data. It means this kind of rain gauges do not produce a rainfall data with duration. Okay, it produces a rainfall data of 24 hours at a time. Okay, actually what's happened in India, every day at morning 8:30 a.m. Indian Standard Time, we go to the rain gauge station and we collect the rainfall from the rain gauges and measure it. Okay, and again we set the rain gauge to collect and measure the rainfall data for the next day. Now again on the next day at 8:30 a.m. we go to the rain gauge station and collect the rainfall and measure it. Okay, so next day at 8:30 a.m. again we go to the rain gauge station, collect the the rainfall and measure it. In this way, this kind of rain gauges produces our rainfall data of 24 hours at a time. It means suppose you want a rainfall data or you want to know the rainfall intensity from let's say 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. maybe, but you will not get this kind of data because it do not produce the rainfall data with duration or with time. Okay, now so as I discussed earlier that Simon gauge is the most extensively used non-recording gauge in India. Okay, this is a schematic diagram of Simon gauge. Okay, so a Simon gauge is consist of a metal container, a glass bottle and a funnel. Okay, so what happened when precipitation occur through this funnel, the precipitation or rainfall come into this bottle. Okay, And when we go to the rain gauge station every day at 8:30 a.m. we collect the rainfall from this bottle and we pour it into this measuring glass, okay? And in this way we note down the depth of the rainfall, because you can see here, here is this measuring glass is marked, and from this marking we can calculate the depth of the rainfall or precipitation, okay? Generally the depth of the foundation below the ground level for this Simon gauge is minimum of 50 centimeter, okay? And above the ground level the height of the Simon gauge is 30 centimeter. See, you can see this height is 25 centimeter and this height is 5 centimeter, so total 30 centimeter. And below the ground level its height is 5 centimeter, okay? So these are the, you know, the dimensions of Simon gauge. Now recently IMD is Indian Meteorological Department, has changed some standard of the Simon gauge, okay? Means it the Indian Meteorological Department has modified some, you know, some characteristic of Simon gauge. So what type of change that has been made by IMD? The first change is, you can see in the older type of Simon gauge, the collecting bottle, the rain collecting bottle is a glass bottle, okay? Means the bottle made of glass. But in the modified version of Simon gauge, the material of the bottle is fiberglass reinforced polyester, okay? Now in this modified version of Simon gauge, the size of the bottle is different type. You can use 2 liter bottle, you can use 4 liter bottle, or you can use 10 liter bottle. According to your requirement, you can use the different type of bottle. Suppose in an area where you know from the past precipitation data that the in those area the rainfall is higher, then in those area you can use maybe a 10 liter bottle. And suppose in a area the rainfall from the past data you may know the rainfall is very less, so you may use there the 2 liter bottle, okay? Now if you want to know the installation process and the process of measurement of rainfall from this kind of modified Simon gauge, then you have to go through from Indian standard 4986-1968, okay? Because in this standard the installation and measurement of rainfall by this modified Simon gauge has been written, okay? And if you want to know the various details about this modified Simon gauge, then you should go through Indian standard 5225-1992 or maybe 5225-1969, okay? Now we are going to discuss about recording gauges. So as I discussed that the main disadvantage of non-recording gauges are they do not produce the rainfall data with time, okay? It means suppose if you want to know a rainfall intensity for a particular time in a particular day, you will not be able to get those kind of data from non-recording gauges. But the recording gauges provide a continuous plot of rainfall. It means the recording gauges provide a continuous data of rainfall with duration. It means suppose if you want to know the rainfall intensity in a day for a particular time, suppose you want to know rainfall intensity from maybe 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. then with the help of this recording gauge, you will be calculate or you will be able to, you know, measure the rainfall data for a particular time in a day, okay? So this kind of recording gauges are also known as self-recording gauge or automatic recording gauge or integrating rain gauges, okay? Actually, this type of rain gauges has an automatic mechanical arrangement, okay, which consists of a clockwork drum, a paper, a pen, okay, which draws a mass curve of rainfall. Okay, so what is this mass curve of rainfall? See, we will discuss about this mass curve of rainfall in the consequent lectures, but for the time being, just get the knowledge that this mass curve of rainfall is the plot between the accumulated precipitation, or you can say cumulative rainfall, versus the time or duration. See, you can see here, this is the mass curve of rainfall. So in the x-axis you have accumulated precipitation, or you can say it as cumulative rainfall with, and in the x-axis you have time, or maybe you can say it duration. Okay, so from this mass curve we can calculate or measure the intensity of rainfall at a particular time. Okay, so actually this clockwork drum, you know, set the time scale, and with the paper and the pen, actually this pen, you know, draws the mass curve of rainfall in this paper. Okay, now the first type of recording gauge is tipping bucket type recording gauge. Okay, this tipping bucket type recording gauge is consist of a receiver, a funnel and two tipping buckets. Okay, and also a measuring glass or measuring tube. So see, this is the receiver, and the diameter of the receiver is 30 centimeter. Okay, and this is the receiving funnel. Now just below the receiving funnel a pair of small buckets are provided, and these buckets are known as tipping buckets. Okay, see, these are the buckets. Okay, these buckets are so balanced, when a bucket receives a rainfall of 0.25 mm, it tips and empties into the tank. This is the tank, you know, this is the tank. And when a bucket tips and empties into the tank below, the other bucket takes its position, and this process is continuous. It means what happens, you know, suppose these two are buckets. Okay, see, suppose these two are buckets. Okay, so what happened when, suppose this is number one bucket and this is number second bucket. Okay, so when 0.25 mm rainfall, you know, it fall here, means when this particular bucket receives a rainfall of 0.25 mm, it tips down, and the other bucket actually takes its position. Okay, now again, when this particular bucket, you know, receives a rainfall of 0.25 mm, again it tips down, and this particular bucket come to its position, and this process is just going on again and again. Okay, the tipping of bucket makes the pen move into the chart. Okay, actually here a pen is attached, you know, let me use another color. So here a pen is attached. Okay, and with the pen here also a paper is attached. Okay, a paper is attached. Now when the bucket tips down, the tipping of the bucket makes the pen move on the paper, and in this way this pen draws the mass rainfall curve on the paper. Okay, and from the mass rainfall curve we may calculate or measure the rainfall intensity at a particular time. Okay, now what is the purpose of this measuring tube? Now when this particular tank, you know, it reaches its maximum capacity, we just open this particular knob. Okay, and the water or the rainfall falls into the, you know, this measuring tube, and by collecting the rainfall from this measuring tube we may cross check the data that has been plotted by this pen in this particular paper. Okay, now the second type of recording gauge is weighing bucket type recording gauge. Okay, this type of recording gauge is consist of a receiver, a receiving funnel, a bucket, a weighing mechanism. Okay, see, this is the receiver. Okay, this is the receiver. Receiver, or you can say it's a collector also, and this is the receiving funnel, and this is the catch bucket, and a weighing mechanism. Okay, this is the weighing mechanism. Here the weighing mechanism is the spring balance. Okay, it is the weighing mechanism for this particular case. Okay, now when a certain amount of or certain weight of rainfall is collected by the tank, you know, this particular tank just moves down due to the weight. Okay, and as you see here, this bucket is rest on a spring lever balance, and when this bucket is moves down, the movement of the bucket makes the pin move on the chart, which is wrapped on the clock driven drum. Okay, you can see this is the chart, this is the chart, and this is the pin. You can see here, this is the pin. Okay, now when, so as I said, the when this bucket moves down, due to the movement of this bucket, this pin move on the chart. Okay, and this revolving drum, this revolving drum set the time scale. Okay, now with the help of this revolving drum, pen and the chart, this particular recording gauge produces the or draws the mass rainfall curve, and from the mass rainfall curve we may get the intensity, or you know, the measurement of rainfall in a particular time. Okay, so this is the mechanism of this weighing bucket type rain gauge. Now the third type of recording gauge is float type recording gauge. You can also call this as natural siphon type recording gauge. Okay, let me write it here, natural siphon type. Okay, now this type of recording gauge is consist of a siphon, a float. See, this is the siphon, this is the float. Okay, and it also consists of a float chamber, a siphon chamber, and a funnel. Okay, so now when precipitation occurs through this funnel, you know, water or the rainfall water comes in this float chamber. Now when the float chamber fills up with water, the float moves up. Okay, and when the float moves up, you know, it makes the pen move on the chart, which is wrapped round a clock driven drum. Okay, you can see here, this is the paper and here is the pen, and when this float moves up, it makes the pen, okay, move on the chart, which is wrapped round a clock driven drum. Okay, and in this way the mass rainfall curve is drawn in the paper. Okay, now you may ask me, then what is the function or the purpose of this siphon? See, this is the siphon. Okay, actually what happens when the float chamber reaches its maximum capacity, it means when the float chamber filled with rainfall water in this in the manner that there is no space to come more amount of rainfall, and that time this siphon tube suck the extra amount of water and remove that water from the float chamber. Okay, so this is the main function or purpose of siphon type, you know, recording gauge, or natural siphon type recording gauge, or you can say it as float type recording gauge. Okay, so this is the detailed discussion about various type of rain gauge. Okay, now So we have discussed about the various type of rain gauges, but we should know what are the precautions that we should take while setting up a rain gauge. So the first point is the ground surface must be leveled on which the rain gauge is going to place. Okay, it means the surface on which the rain gauge is going to be placed, that ground surface has to be leveled. Okay, now the second point is the gauge must be set as near the ground as possible to reduce the wind effect. Okay, this will be T, to reduce the wind effect, but it must be sufficiently high to prevent the flooding. Okay, so the point is self-explanatory. Actually, to reduce the wind effect, we need to set the rain gauge as near as possible to the ground. Okay, now the third point is the instrument must be surrounded by an open fenced of at least 5.5 into 5.5 meter. Okay, now see, this is our rain gauge. Okay, now this rain gauge is surrounded by an open fence of 5.5 meter into 5.5 meter. Now why we should use use this kind of fence just around this rain gauge? This is because, you know, if we don't provide this kind of fence, maybe some animals like cow, buffalo or goat may come nearer to this rain gauges, and they may hamper the rainfall data. Suppose they drink water from that rain gauge. In this way, they may hamper the data. Okay. Now the last point is no object should be nearer to the instrument than 30 meter or twice. It means, suppose, let me use another color. Suppose this is our rain gauge station. Okay, this is our rain gauge station or rain gauge. Actually, this is our rain gauge. Okay, and this is a object, and the height of this object is, suppose, h. Now, according to this point, the distance between this rain gauge and this object should be 30 meter or twice of the height of this object, whichever is more. Okay, this means the distance between this rain gauge and this object, you know, should be 30 meter or 2h, whichever is more, whichever is more. Okay, now so this is the detailed discussion about rain gauges. Okay, now we are going to discuss about rain gauge network. Okay, or it is also called as rain gauge density. Rain gauge density. Okay, actually the number of rain gauge installed in a given area is known as rain gauge density. Okay, it means, suppose a area of 1 kilometer. In this area of 1 kilometer, there are 3 rain gauges are installed. Okay, it means the rain gauge density of this 1 kilometer square area is 3. Okay, now for accurate data, the number of rain gauge should be maximum. Okay, see, we know from the statistics, to get the accurate data, the sample size should be more. Okay, so to get accurate data means to get accurate data of rainfall, the number of rain gauge should be maximum. It means the rain gauge density should be maximum. But due to various reasons like economy, topography, or accessibility, the number of rain gauges are minimum. Okay. Now, WMO means World Meteorological Organization has some recommendations about the rain gauge density. So, according to WMO, in the flat region, the ideal numbers of rain gauge is, you know, one station for 600 to 900 kilometers square, and the acceptable is one station for 900 to 3000 kilometers square. Okay. Now, in a mountainous region, the ideal is one station for 100 to 250 kilometers square. See, this will be one. Okay. This will be one. And the acceptable is one station for 25 to 1000 kilometers square. Okay. And in arid zone or polar zone, the one station for 1500 to 10,000 kilometers square, depending upon the feasibility. Actually, in the arid zone or the, you know, the in the polar zone, the amount of rainfall or precipitation is very less. So, depending upon the feasibility, you may install one station for 1500 to 10,000 kilometers square. Okay. Now, the Indian Standard 4987-1994 has given some recommendations for rain gauge density. So, according to Indian Standard 4987, in plain area, one station has to be there within 500 kilometers square, and the region which has an elevation of 1000 kilometer, for those region or those area, there should be one station for 250 to 400 kilometers square area. Okay. Now, with that, it is desirable to have 10% of this rain gauge station are equipped with self-recording rain gauges. It means if we have 100 numbers of rain gauges, out of this 100 numbers of rain gauges, there should be minimum 10 recording type rain gauges. Okay. Now, this is a note, important note, that in India, there is only one station per 600 kilometer square area, which is very less. Okay. Because in the other countries, there are one station per, you know, 100 kilometer square. The Israel has the maximum rain gauge density. It has a rain gauge density of 37 in every 1000 kilometer square area, whereas the India has only 16 rain gauges in 1000 kilometer square area. Which is comparatively less. Okay. So, this is it for today. If you have any doubt, please do comment. I will try to, you know, explain your doubts. Okay. Thank you.